Hello, my name is Danny Nolan and I'm the director of ChassisSim Technologies. And today, ladies and gentlemen, I want to present to you a tutorial that I think has been a bit long overdue. And today what we're going to be talking about is suspension geometry and ChassisSim, how we go about connecting the dots. Because with regards to ChassisSim, it's pretty well documented in terms of how ChassisSim approaches about the approaches that we use for suspension geometry, and the mechanics of it are relatively straightforward. But what I've been most remiss not doing is providing you all with a guide about how you go through and connect the dots and really how you tie this all together. So that's our goal for today. Now, unless you've been living under a rock for the last nearly 50 years, when we come to geometry, it's a hot button topic. I mean, if you want to start a barroom brawl with a bunch of race engineers, just walk in and just say that the horizontal location of the roll center is nothing more than a beat you up, and then all of a sudden just watch all hell break loose. Now, here's the thing. ChassisSim does geometry really, really well, and we've got an extremely well-proven track record on it. That being said, as I've alluded to earlier, sometimes what's been lacking a little bit is how you go about connecting the dots, and we're going to talk about that, and I'm also going to show you what you can do with it. So let's get started. Okay, first things first, before we talk about turning ChassisSim on, before we talk about how you go through and use the various features, we've got to talk about the suspension geometry datum that ChassisSim uses. Because if you don't measure the points in right, you might as well pack up and go home. So with ChassisSim, the suspension geometry datum is the front axle center line of the car on the ground. And as you can see, it's very, very aptly illustrated here. X runs back along the longitudinal axis of the car, Z is vertical, Y is to the right. But honestly, for those of you who are using either a symmetric or an asymmetric car, enter your Y coordinates as absolute values, because what ChassisSim will do internally is it will convert them to the appropriate signs that it needs. So first things first, get the datum right, the front axle center line on the ground. Once you've got that, X going down the longitudinal axis of the car, Z up, Y is laterally across the car. Understand that, everything else is going to flow downstream. Okay, entering these points in the ChassisSim. Now, a quick prelim here. What you need to do here, because the default ChassisSim for the suspension geometry is meters. Now, while strictly speaking, this is totally correct, to use it can sometimes be a little bit clunky, unless, of course, you've got about 500 degrees in rocket science and dream about 20 or 40 differential equations. So what you need to do here is that you can configure this into the units you need. So if you go into ChassisSim, go into the view menu, go select units to use, change the geometry length to your liking. So as you can see, I've highlighted here in the red, you've got the suspension geometry length, and you can choose meters, millimeters, or inches. Now, I choose to work in millimeters. For those of you in the United States, you might want to work in inches. The choice is totally up to you. I choose to work in millimeters because of the fact I just find that a bit more intuitive to use. But you use whatever you are the most comfortable with, because they're going to be the units that the geometry viewer is going to return to, that the geometry viewer and the geometry input dialogues are going to return to you. Okay, entering this into ChassisSim. Don't worry, we're going to go through a practical demonstration of this momentarily. But one thing I do want to take this opportunity now is just to really highlight what these points are. And as you can tell, I clearly made my living as an engineer and a vehicle dynamicist, not as an illustrator. So what we've got here is that point one is your lower wishbone forward point. Point two is your lower wishbone aft point. Point three is the lower location on the hub. Point four is the upper wishbone forward point. Five is the upper wishbone aft point, and six is the upper point on the hub. So that's pretty much the lay of the land. And don't get me wrong, we will be talking about the analyze configuration and apply calc shortly when we do the practical demonstration. But bottom line, whenever you put in all of these points, I always click on analyze configuration as a sanity check. That is a very, very important step because it just makes sure you don't do anything silly. But that's all right. I'm going to reiterate that shortly. And then when you click on apply calc, that will apply it to what ChassisSim is going to see. So they're two very important points. So let's hook into that. So let's hook into that right now. So what I'm going to do here is I've got ChassisSim up. And so in order to access the geometry in ChassisSim, I've got two options. I can either click on the wishbone or I can go to the tree structure and click on suspension geometry. Whatever you choose, totally up to you. Now, let's now click on our geometry tab. So you can see here there are a couple of buttons for you to choose from. Click here to adjust points. When it comes to changing suspension geometry in ChassisSim, this is where you're going to be spending the bulk of your time. However, let me just have a quick word about bump steer and Ackerman. As you can see in our earlier PowerPoint demonstration, you can see that with ChassisSim, you seem to have a pretty basic set of points to choose from. And that's actually been done for two very deliberate reasons. Number one, keeping it simple so that you don't overly complicate it, so you don't have a menu of 20 points and you're figuring, good God, what do I need to fill in here? So that that's keeping it simple. But also to the other reason that we haven't really gone that point and why we've got things like where you can manually go through, enter a bump steer table and enter an Ackerman table is that two reasons. Number one, you've got software packages like SUSPROG and very sadly the now defunct WinGeo, and very sadly the reason WinGeo is now defunct is that Bill Mitchell, its creator, passed away quite a few years ago. It's a real pity because Bill left the party way too early. And 90% of the time, it gets the bump steer tables and the Ackerman tables absolutely spot on. And ditto with the motion ratios as well. And they're always a very, very good point to start to go from doing things like bump steer, Ackerman, motion ratios, things like SUSPROG and WinGeo do a great job of it. But there's a big but here. The big but is that 90% of the time, they're fantastic. 10% of the time, they can lead you down the garden path, which is why with ChassisSim, we force you to fill in these tables manually so you know you've got it right. Also, with the advent of the ChassisSim scripting, if you've got some different suspension configurations that will reflect different bump steers and different Ackerman properties, they can actually all be incorporated as part of the ChassisSim scripting. However, let's get on to the meat, which is where you're going to be spending the bulk of your time with suspension geometry. And indeed, this is pretty much your first order of effects, which is our geometry table. Now, again, to reiterate, the ChassisSim datum, front axle centerline on the deck, on the ground, terra firma. X runs back to the car, Y runs across, Z is up. And again, to reiterate, with regards to your lateral values in ChassisSim, you enter these as absolute values. Even if you're running asymmetric, ChassisSim will automatically take that into account. Now, so you go through, you enter in your values, and your first step is you always click on Analyze Configuration. Now, the reason that you click on Analyze Configuration is to make sure that you haven't done something silly. Now, here's the thing, and this is something I talk about at length in the boot camps, and I've seen this done a million and one times. You go through, you measure up the car, you think everything is great, you get back to the office, the car's back together in one piece, you go through, plug in the points, and you get a roll center of like minus 400 millimeters or plus 1,000 millimeters, anti-dive, anti-squats of like 5,000%, minus 5,000%. And more often than not, what's happened is that you've gone through and you haven't measured a point properly, which is why when you're measuring up a car, and I've talked about this in my How to Measure Up a Car video, and I also ram this point here at the boot camp, and I'm ramming this point home today, is the fact that you always do this as you're measuring up the car. Once you have done that, you click on Apply Calc. And what that does is that that applies the pitch sensors, anti-dive, anti-squat, and the roll sensors. Now, ChassisSim uses this as a sanity check when it's going through and adjusting all these hard points. The other thing that I want to point out, the other important thing that you've got to put in here, is the right height at which this has been measured at. Because as the right height varies in ChassisSim, that's going to tell ChassisSim how these points need to be moved up and down. So that's really important. Now, one of the things that we've got coming down the road with ChassisSim version 3.43 is we've just added this new feature here. Click here to show instant center and swing arm length. So this is actually, I was working on a hypercar job back in 2022, and this proved to be really, really useful in the fact that it shows you your instant center locations laterally and longitudinally, and it shows you the swing arm length. So this way you can sanity check what it's actually doing. It's actually a really, really useful feature, particularly if you're designing geometry. Sure, it doesn't have the bells and whistles of, say, something like SUSPROG or Optimum K. That's not the point. The point is a very quick visualization tool so you can go, oh, hang on, that doesn't quite look right. And then you can go, back here and adjust them, and then have a look here. Now, one of the things that I will say, that when you do that, make sure you always press on Analyze Configuration and your instant centers and swing arm lengths, both laterally and longitudinally, will be adjusted to suit. Once you've done that, the other thing too that you can do with ChassisSim is that you can either export the settings and import the settings. Now, export the settings, that's going to be used for the ChassisSim scripting. But you can also use the import settings. And then again, that's used both in the ChassisSim scripting and in here, where you can very, very quickly import settings. Like, for example, if I've got a situation where I'm sanity checking a model, what I'll often do is I'll get a base model, I'll get the screwed up model. And what I'll do is, particularly with the geometries, I will click on export settings. And on the newer model, I'll click on import settings, run the simulation, then I can see, okay, what's screwed up here? Or indeed, if this is the culprit. But the much more important spin-off of this, ladies and gentlemen, is that you can now go into suspension analysis and you can click on load geometry. And you can load as many geometries in here as you wish. Actually, I'll tell a little white light, load in about 5. And this will tell you your left-hand roll center and your left camber. And again, it doesn't have the bells and whistles of something like SUSPROG or Optimum K, but it's a great little tool that if you need to make quick changes, you can just dive into here and say, oh, hang on, we shifted the upper hub point up by about 10 mil. What did that do in terms of both the roll center and the camber gain? And here you get an immediate answer. And if you go into the export settings configuration, you can do all that and tie this all together. Now, in my other video where I talk about the ChassisSim suspension geometry viewer, I talk about using this tool at length. So I will refer you to that video, but again, I just wanted to touch on that. So that is pretty much your nuts and bolts about how you tie this all together. The other thing that ChassisSim also does is the fact that if you're doing a lap time simulation, a track replay, or drive in the loop, this is all exported as part of the data set. So here's an example of a geometry configuration that I've put together, and so we can see the cambers front and rear, the roll center front, the roll center rear, and the anti-dives and anti-squats. Now, a couple of things about this. Number one, this is a force-based roll center and pitch center. I've discussed this at length on multiple occasions, and it's beyond our scope to talk in more in depth about it right now. But if you really want to know the nub of what drives suspension geometry, it all revolves around force-based roll and pitch centers. Now, I talk about that. I give you all the proofs in my book, The Dynamics of the Race Car, Chapter 3 in particular. I've also done a number of different tutorials on that, so no need to labor this point. And it also gives you the camber. So, let's sum up. Entering suspension geometry into ChassisSim is easy. It's not rocket science, and I am a rocket scientist. You just need to know how to connect the dots. Once the penny drops in how to connect the dots, you're going to be up and away with all the features we've just discussed. You've also got a quick static viewer, and all of this is returned in the lap time simulation, the rack tree play, and driver in the loop sim. So at this point, let me wrap up the video. For those of you who are already ChassisSim users, by all means, have a go at this. Throw some mud on the wall. But for those of you who aren't, ChassisSim users yet, you can get your feet wet with our online simulation. And we will catch you in the next ChassisSim video tutorial.